not because it's a command, but because it's an opportunity to expand who you are. Remember earlier tonight when I said you're leaders in the world? You're leaders in your life. If you're not a leader in your life, get out there and start leading. They're waiting. You're not going to walk home, go home tonight and have someone say, stop, you can't lead over here. No leaders allowed. No, they're like going, they're hungry for you. They go, gee, I hope she will. Would she just invite me again? I know I said no last time. I might say no again, but I want her to keep telling me, him, whoever you are. So the question is this, what can you see as the relationship between this conversation for inauthentic fear and having enrollment conversations out there and sharing inviting people to the Landmark Farm? Shout it out, I want to hear from you. What's the relationship? What's been holding you back? What's fear of failure got to do with inviting people? Tell me.
Afraid that they don't want
to
come, or say no, or
yeah.
Say get away.
Yeah, definitely afraid they won't say no. What if they said no? What would that mean about you, Kiyomi?
Not a good salesperson.
Yeah, you're a terrible salesperson. Well, I'm not asking you to sell yourself, I'm asking you to share yourself.
But we sell ourselves all the time.
You do. Sharing yourself is, you could say, if you're a salesperson, you might say, well, that's what I do. I just share myself and people, you know, buy my cars. But you are not selling the Landmark Farm. You're sharing who you are. You're sharing who you are. Yes, Ceci. Wow, how are we going to do this?
I haven't invited nobody.
I haven't invited anybody, okay.
I have two daughters, they're big, they're old.
Loud, Ricardo.
I have two daughters, they're old already. They are the ones that brought us, me and Mateo, here to Landmark.
Okay.
And they already have invited all the family, and I said, well, they can keep doing that.
Okay, they can. Okay. And what is it that now stops you from inviting your next door neighbor or the grocery clerk? Or the pharmacist, or the person at your church. You see her or him every Sunday if you go there. I'm not telling you where to look, but I am telling you to look. I'm saying, don't stop. Are you willing to take that on, Ceci? Yeah, what if you fail?
No problem.
Not a problem.
No.
No.
Seguiré insistiendo después.
I will keep insisting.
You keep insisting. You want to keep insisting.
Insisting.
And you'll keep insisting. Okay, great. Anything else?
Oh, okay. We went to Oregon recently.
Yeah.
Mi esposo tiene mucha familia allá.
My husband has a lot of family over there.
Hubiera querido tener tiempo para hablar, pero fue muy poquito tiempo que estuvimos ahí.
I wish to have more time to talk to all of them, but we weren't there for a long time.
Yeah. Did you invite anyone?
Quiero saber si hay allá en Oregon.
¿Invitaste a alguien?
No, pero quiero saber si allá hay en
Oregon. No, but I want to know.
Quiero hacer.
No, but I want to know if there's a center in Oregon so they can do it over there.
Portland.
Portland.
Yeah.
Portland?
Yeah.
Oh, it's close.
Yeah, okay, good. Okay, so now a whole new territory just opened up. Okay, now what's it going to take to get beyond your fear of failure about that? Anything? Or are you ready to go?
¿Tienes miedo para hacerlo o estás lista para competir? I've been ready since I got here.
I can't hear you. Say it again.
I've been ready since I started the seminar.
You've been ready since you started the seminar?
Yes.
Okay, good. Go do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Invite someone to come here and be with you next week. Okay. Yeah, it's going to take some doing. Everyone, invite someone to be with you at the seminar next week. Be the leader. You're all just petrified. So invite somebody that you haven't invited. I have a cousin, I mean a nephew. His name is Scott. He has a brother whose name is Uris. And Uris, and I talked yesterday, I've never invited him. He's 27, 28 years old. He's going to be a doctor. And I said, you know, I want to invite you and Scott to the Landmark Forum. But we have to have a conversation about that. Are you open? He said, yeah, I'm open. I said, great. He said, I can't do it right now. And I went, okay, great. When can we go? Saturday. Now, I was not calling him up to invite him to be at my seminar next week, but I'm going to do it. He has to come from Minneapolis, actually Minnesota, not just Minneapolis. Is he going to do it? I don't know. I don't know. But something broke open for me yesterday. I'm on the car, driving, talking, well, not like that, but you know, talking on the phone. And I said, I want you to come and do the Landmark Forum. He said, well, I'm really kind of interested. I was knocked back. But I've been holding back all these years, and I just finally, I was working on the assignment. I said, get over it. Just invite him. So just invite people. Who's going to do that? Just try it out. Raise your hand if you're going to do that this week. Raise your hand. Just be straight. Okay, good. Who's going to take some chances? Yeah. All right, great. See, it's inauthentic fear that stops it. Just stops you cold. What else? I want to get in your world. I want to hear from you what's going on. Yes.
Question. Why does this inauthentic fear or fear of rejection
or
someone saying no sometimes
really
hurts? I mean, it hurts
sometimes.
Not really,
it's inauthentic. But emotionally? Emotionally it hurts, but your emotions are just what people have emotions. That hurts real, but you're not hurt. There's no bullet flying in your direction.
So I know that, but it still hurts.
But what you want to do is stop resisting that it's inauthentic. That's an inauthentic fear, the fear of having a painful emotion. People have painful emotions every day. It's inauthentic. It's not that the emotion is inauthentic, it's that you give significance to it. Yes, Ryan.
Yeah.
Go for it.
People go to movies to, on purpose, have painful emotions. Have you ever gone to a movie on purpose, a sad movie, to have a painful emotion on purpose? You got to reduce the significance of painful emotions.
You are not satisfied. I can see it in your face.
Well, it's different. It's pleasure. The painful emotion of a movie, it's not real, and it's not enjoyable, but some pain, it can last and it can paralyze you.
Yeah, that's inauthentic fear.
Right, I know, but
yeah.
It still does.
I know, but that's what you're doing, is resisting it. Stop resisting it. Give up resisting it. Try that on. This is a new life for you. Some of you are like shocked that I would ask you to do such a thing. It's your fear of failure that stops you. It just paralyzes you. You make it so significant, it hurts my feelings. That's an interesting story. At the movies, it's a very interesting story. You pay money for it. But you have it, and that's real, and that's how it goes, and that's your life, and that's the truth about you. It's not. It's not even close to the truth about you. Now, a lot of you are going to go, oh, he's this, that Fred, mean bad advice. You get what I just said? Mm-hmm. It's just ridiculous.
So I have a story. I'm afraid of heights.
You're afraid of heights? That's another thing. I can't deal with that. Isn't that psychological or something? I don't know. You can overcome anything.
Yeah.
We're going to move faster. But I really want to have you take this on. And some of you are sitting in your freaks right now just quaking in your boots like I'm going to call you up at 4 a.m. and tell you to go invite somebody. No, I am telling you right now, get over your fear and share yourself, your authentic self. You're so damned afraid to be who you are. You sit in these seats week after week after week, and you invent something new for yourself, and you walk to your car and it's done. And then you come back for another dose, like a shot or something. I don't know what that is. You've got to get that you are the leader. Your hands are not up. I'm wondering why. And really, I don't care why. I'm interested to know your story. That part's interesting. But I'm more interested in you getting. You are inauthentic when it comes to being so stingy. You come in here, you want to have a great life, and then you go be stingy. Who are you ripping off? I've been ripping off my nephew Scott for years. Own it. And go make a difference. Who's got a question? Anybody? Okay, I think I did a little soapbox there. Did I just kill off the room here? Yeah. Real fast, yeah, please. But something really big and important.
It was about enrollment and advice.
Go for it.
Our group had a call Monday night, and we were discussing the pressure we feel about enrolling and inviting. And I took away from the conversation that if there is the completion of the action of enrolling, which is inviting, but when I started having conversations that were more just, like, it's like 80% share, and then there's just that simple question of, you want to check it out? Like I think as a group we were taking away, like all of a sudden we're salespeople. And it was a little overwhelming.
Yeah,
well, this pressure,
it,
but it
take
really,
out the sales tech.
Yeah, it shifted when I just started. People are like, oh, what have you been up to? You've lost weight, or you're doing this, or I see this and this and da da da. I'm like, oh, well, like, you know, I've been doing this and doing this, and then they kind of have these conversations with you, and you start to. I always worry I'm going to be junior landmark on them, and then I'm like, I'm just doing this thing called landmark. And then it's a curiosity question, but I think it's more about the share, and I know there seems to be the emphasis on the invite, and those are the words we hear more.
I don't say that. I don't go, and now invite!
I got a lot of text messages.
You sure do. And they're never going to stop. They're never going to stop, Megan.
I know.
And here's why.
But I think we connect more to the action than the share.
I got that.
The invite versus share.
I got that. That's all inauthentic fear
Brian
of failure.
Clarify it.
It's all inauthentic fear of failure. I got it. I'm not. I've been there. I know that space really well. But just consider.
The takeaway is just share.
Yeah, well, what if you just took away the significance of it all? What if you just took away the significance? Someone invited you. Did you get conned? Who got conned? You got conned, you're not here. You got conned because you're here because you got conned?
I went to a graduation.
Did you get conned? Did you? And is that why you signed up? You like being conned?
Well, that's what brought me to this. They'll come to my graduation, and I was like, oh, I'll be supporting friends. And then it was a whole different ballgame.
Yeah, and then it was a whole different ballgame, and was it the conning that had you register?
No, I appreciated the information. Exactly. How I got there was...
Exactly.
Not great.
Yeah, you didn't get conned. Your friend conned you and said, come for graduation. Right, didn't even take you to dinner?
Oh, no.
Oh, you got dinner? Well, good for you. All right, so, but you want to get, that's not a con. There's never been a Landmark Forum leader alive who has conned you. Nor am I conning you. You know why? Because I care. And so do you. And it's inauthentic of you not to carry your caring out into the world and make a difference. It's completely inauthentic of you. You've got to confront that. That's the confront. I'm not telling you here that you have to go invite people. I'm telling you, if you have words that matter and you're going to make a difference in another human being's life, will you please do it? Will you please do it? We live in a world that needs you, and you pretend that you make no difference. Ha! Marta.
This is my resistance. My daughter and my son have come to the seminar actually because my daughter invited me and then my son. And I see the changes in them. And I'm afraid, like when I share with somebody, because I haven't assimilated or I haven't put everything in the my real life.
Yes.
To like, I'm not going to be honest, and this is very important, and I have, but I don't know.
I do get the idea. I get the idea, and it's completely inauthentic. I love what you've just said. I don't want to diminish in any way what you've said, but you got transformed. Marta, you're here. That's what I'm talking about. You keep denying yourself.
Yeah.
You keep pretending that you haven't gotten something called transformation, the capacity out of your own speaking to make a difference in the life of another human being. You keep pretending. That's the inauthenticity. Go make a difference. What if every one of you, everyone, I don't know how many are in the room right now, 35 people, something like that. What if we had 35 guests in this room? Like, we wouldn't have space for everybody. They'd be like over there in the corner, we'd have so many people. And the difference in the spirit of this room would be 1,000-fold greater than it is at this very moment when you're all feeling like guilty kids. It just makes me sick. I don't want you to be guilty kids. I don't care about that stuff. I care about you having your life be great. Who's going to take it on? Like, you got to, like, get out there. Who's going to take it on? Raise your hand. You're going to keep resisting. You're just going to keep resisting, keep resisting. Raise your hand, be proud. That's it? One person? Two people? Three people? Okay, I'm not counting anymore, but... Okay, so some of you. But some of you are just going to keep resisting and make up reason after reason after reason. It's all reasonable. Somebody stood for you. It's a good thing they weren't you. You wouldn't be here. Really. It's a good thing. They weren't you, because you would not be sitting in these seats tonight. Okay, we're going to talk about responsibility next. We've got so much to go. Oh my goodness, all right, so we're now going to get into one of the most powerful distinctions of our work here at Landmark. This is one of the most powerful, I keep saying it every week and I keep saying it, because it is, it's one of the most powerful distinctions we've got. Called the distinction responsibility as a context for life. So responsibility, the way we distinguish it as a possibility, is one of the most empowering distinctions in our work. The work is transformation. So here at Landmark, we have a very specific way of deciding.